A warm fall day made for the perfect environment.
It is my happy space. You know, I can just run and I can be in a zone and not think about it.
That outlook is a change of pace from what Shanika McCoy once thought about running.
So when I first looked at it, I was like, who wants to go run for just for fun?
She grew up doing gymnastics and dance, so she was no stranger to being active. But a lot changed after she was diagnosed with intracranial hypertension in 2006.
I would have different symptoms. The doctor told me, you know, I could possibly go blind. And at that point, that was a big scare for me. The doctor, you know, he explained, Ms. McCoy, you have to do something about your health. And that's when I took action.
Shanika got back into the gym and started changing her lifestyle overall.
How did you get serious in really putting the action behind the changes you wanted to make?
It took being on medication that I didn't want to be on, and the symptoms that came with the medication. And so I was like, I don't want this.
She started a Couch to 5K program through the American Heart Association. That was 10 years ago, and Shanika has steadily pushed herself ever since.
Looking at it as longevity.
Running in different races across the country, many of them have marathons.
I don't so much think about it as being competitive so much, more so competitive with myself versus others. But whenever it came to being competitive with others, and it was like, okay, like I can run faster than what I did 5 years ago or 6 years ago.
This year, she hit another personal milestone. She ran the Chicago Marathon, her first full marathon.
You just never know who you're inspiring. And, you know, when others come to you and they say that, oh, you're such an inspiration, I'm like, oh, I just did this. But it's not something to water down as a self thing, because that's pretty huge. Not everyone does that, especially in our Black community.
Shanika is intentional about sharing her journey with African Americans who aren't runners in hopes they'll strongly consider the physical and emotional benefits of being part of this community.
I like the way it made me feel mentally, and there were trials that I went through, you know, throughout that time from then up until now, where it was more so of a coping mechanism for me. Through my friends, through my church family, and just being able to share, and you know, they most definitely, you know, they want to know your story. So they will ask questions like, oh, I wish I could be like you. Well, yeah, you can, you know, in your own way.